Hey guys, Michael here with the Daily Note. Welcome to part 5 of what's new on Android 4.4 for the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. Today, let's look at the screen recording feature that's now built into Android 4.4. And let's also look at a few changes that came with Android 4.4 that you should be aware of, such as why you can't write to the SD card from any app. So let's get started. Before we start, here's a question I wanted to ask you guys. Did you guys get the one-handed operation mode for all screens? I actually received this update after I upgraded to Android 4.3, but considering my carrier was one of the last ones to receive the Android 4.3 update, I figured that maybe people who didn't get it would get it with the Android 4.4 update. To enable it, you would have to go to Settings, My Device, One-Handed Operation, and go to Use for All Screens. If you did or didn't get it in your Android 4.4 update, please let me know in the comments. If you didn't get it, there are some alternatives to enabling this feature using a custom ROM after you root the device. The hurdles and pitfalls of rooting have increased since Android 4.3 and Nox, so I would only attempt it if you have rooted before and you really need this update. So let's look at screen recording. Screen recording is a way to record high quality video captures of what's on your screen currently. Maybe you want to make a video of some gameplay for YouTube, or you want to create a video tutorial for the app you've written. Screen recording is probably the best way to get the highest quality results. However, to enable screen recording, it is a bit of a hassle. First, you have to make sure you have the official Samsung drivers installed on your computer. An easy way to install the official drivers for your Note 2 is to install Samsung keys. Next, you need an executable file called adb.exe. It is probably best if you just Google it from the web. Third, enable debugging on your Note 2. Once you got all that set up, run this command that you see on the screen. You can lower the bitrate to something lower if your device is running sluggish, but you will be lowering the quality of your video as well. And the time limit is limited to 3 minutes, which is up to 180 seconds. If you've rooted your device, this is where rooting comes in handy. There are some paid apps that let you start recording without having to connect to your PC first, and there is no time limit. Next, let's look at the new limitation you may encounter with Android 4.4. You will see that your apps are no longer able to write freely to any location in the SD card. I'll attempt it by moving this file in my storage to the root of my SD card and you'll notice that it'll fail. It is because Google has locked down where apps can write to for the purposes of security and keeping the SD card clean from stray files. This limitation has caught a lot of developers off guard and many think it's a bug or a mistake that Google will eventually reverse. I personally think it's going to be enforced for the foreseeable future, so here's a workaround for it. First, while it's true that any apps that you install can't write to the SD card, system apps still can write anywhere on the SD card. For example, if you want to clear up storage, you can use the app My Files on your Galaxy Note 2 to move files from your internal storage to anywhere on the SD card. Second, the apps that you install can still write to an external SD card if the app has requested permission to do so, and the only location it can write to is this path that you see on the screen. Third, Samsung or your carrier can, if they want to, release an update that will lift this restriction. It's a simple setting in a system configuration file. They must have changed it for the Note 3, as you can see here, my Note 3 running Android 4.4 has no problems writing to any location on an SD card. So hopefully Samsung or your carrier will release a small patch when they get around to it. So that's it for today. I think there will be one or two more videos for this series of what's new on Android 4.4 for the Samsung Galaxy Note 2. I'll talk about all the little changes that didn't make it on earlier videos. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe for more videos. And as always, thank you for watching.